Keller, and I'm a digital artist from Mexico. On this tutorial, I'll teach you how to use the 3D capabilities of Adobe Illustrator to create a chess piece. The first thing we're gonna do is go and create a new document, so we're gonna go File, New, and select the size that we feel comfortable with, in this case 800 by 600. My interface may be a little bit different because I'm using the Illustrator CC, but just make sure that you pick 800 by 600 and work on an RGB mode. Now the first thing I'm going to do is create a profile for my piece. So I'm going to go to my tools, and probably by default you're going to see this rectangle tool, but if you click and hold it click, you're going to find the ellipse tool, so or press L on your keyboard. Now let's create one that is 83 by 83. And now I'm going to go and click on the rectangle or press M, and I'm going to create one that is 80 pixels by 30 pixels and press OK. The next thing I want to do is go to my selection tool, select the rectangle, and I'm going to actually control plus to zoom in a little bit, control minus to zoom out a little bit, and then go and round the corners all the way to the center, or you could input the value here on the top of 15 pixels. I'm going to select both of them and go to Window, Align, to bring this window that I had already open here, and then just click on Horizontal Align Center. That way now they are sharing the same axis. I'm going to select again on them and click again on the circle, and you can see how the outline has changed, indicating that that is a key object. Also here you can see the icon has changed to a little key. So I'm going to go here to distribute spacing and just click here to make zero that distance. Now I'm going to go to my pen tool or press P on my keyboard and just make a point here, and then make another point here, another one around here, another one like this, and then just go here and close it on the center. Now everything has a feel that I don't want, so I'm going to remove it. I'm going to go to my direct selection tool or press A on my keyboard and select this anchor point and round them all the way to the center, and the same with this one. Now I can get these curves a little bit better. I'm going to go to my line right here and then click, and then while pressing shift to create a straight line, click on the other side of my piece. I'm going to make sure that everything is aligned to this new line that I just created, and then go to my scissors tool. You can find them here or press the shortcut C. Go and zoom in a little bit to this rectangular shape, and then just click on those anchor points to remove the half. In the case of the circle, I'm going to go to my direct selection tool, select the anchor point on the left, and just press delete on my keyboard. Now I have just the half that I need. I'm going to select it, and while I press Alt and Shift, I'm going to move it to the right to create a copy. That is going to be helpful in the future, but for now we're going to work on this one. So I'm going to change the stroke to this color that I had already selected, then go to Effect, 3D, Revolve. And when you do that and click on the little preview, you can see that the effect has been applied. And if you click here on More Options, you can see the rest of the options. You can change also the angle here. And the first thing I want to do is change the position to isometric top. You can see how that's changed, and actually that's because I made a mistake, sorry. So go and pick isometric right or input the values there. Now I'm going to change the light intensity to 80 and leave everything but the highlight size to 100, and let's change the blend step so it looks smoother to something bigger. So let's give it a try with 90. And now you can change the shading color from black to custom, and then pick a color that you like. In my case, I had already selected one, so 89, 38, 20, and press OK. That's like a brown. In here, you can move manually the highlight, so you can change the direction of it. I'm going to move it actually there to the left. And then I want another light to be on the other side. So I'm going to go here and create a new light. You can see how that has appeared. Move it to the right. Change the intensity of that light, but I'm actually going to move selected light to the back of the object. and you can see how we get that trim light and press OK. Now this is working fine, but the reason they are not looking that way is because they are on the different order. So I'm going to go right click, arrange, send to back, or Control Shift open bracket. I'm going to do the same with the bottom part, and now they are fine. I'm going to move this part a little bit to the bottom so they are sitting right there where they need to be. And here's how I have pound. Now I'm going to use the copy that I created before, go here to my reflect tool or press O, click on one of the anchor points and just reflect it by pressing shift. So you do a minus 90 degrees. Now I'm going to go to my direct selection tool, select the anchor points on the bottom and click here on the top with connected endpoints. I'm going to do the same for the rectangle and the same for this one on the bottom, and you can see that they're a little... So I'm going to just remove that anchor right there. Now I'm going to select everything and go to my Pathfinder window. If you don't have it, you can go to Window, Pathfinder, and click on the first option that is called Unite. Now if I swap the fill with stroke, I can go to my gradient window, and if you don't see it, again go to Window Gradient and apply a gradient. Make sure that you apply the gradient to the fill and not the stroke. Let's change the angle to something like minus 90, and you can see how the pieces are a little bit different because even though they are now united, they are not still intersecting. So I'm going to double click to go inside, move it a little bit to the bottom and just go to unite again. And now you can see how it is a single shape. I'm going to change the opacity of the white color to 0, move a little bit this little slider, and the location is going to be around 60. And then I'm going to go to 3D, rotate. In here you can have again a little preview and move it manually, or again press isometric top. I'm going to move it a little bit here, and then I'm going to send it to back by right click, arrange, send to back. And now I have a little shadow for my pound. What I can do right now is just move it a little bit here, then create a copy again by pressing Alt and Shift. Now I'm going to select the pieces that I use 3D Revolve, and I'm going to change the stroke to black. You can see how that instantly changes the color of my piece. Now I have that brown color that I don't want, so you can go here to the Appearance window, and if you don't have it, again go Window Appearance, and find the 3D Revolve effect. You can click right there to edit it, and just change the shading color preview to black. All the way like 0000, and now you have a black piece. Now finally I'm going to go and create a rectangle by clicking and dragging, so it only has to be a little bit bigger than your canvas. I'm going to swap this, the fill and the stroke, fill it with this brown color and just arrange and send back. Now the shadows are not working anymore, so I'm going to select both. Go to Transparency window, and if you don't have it, go to Window, Transparency, and then go instead of Normal, Multiply, and now you can see how that is looking better. So I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.